The family of Hassan Khalif Shire Ali, the man responsible for Friday's attack, has told Nine News he's not a terrorist. As Neeri Tai explains, the killer's relatives say he was crying for help.
Hassan Khalif Shire Ali was on a mission to slaughter innocent people, but according to those closest, he wasn't a terrorist.
They think that their child had a mental problem. They could not believe their ears when they heard that their son committed this act.
Speaking on behalf of the family, Imam Issei Mussi said the 30-year-old was delusional.
He told them that someone is chasing him. Not only chasing, but with spears, like that.
Shire Ali, the second of six children, grew up in his Werribee home, but became distant with his family. They were too distressed to speak. Instead, his sister gave Nine News a handwritten note. Hassan suffered from mental illness for years and refused help. He's been deteriorating these past few months. He's seen a psychologist and psychiatrist, but stopped as his paranoia and hallucinations led him to believe they are after him. Please stop turning this into a political game. This isn't a guy who had any connections with terrorism, but was simply crying for help. A cry for help that's left a much-loved man dead and a city in mourning.
The family asked me to extend their sympathy to the other family because they are sharing the same grief.
Shire Ali's relationship with his Turkish wife was rocky. They moved into a bungalow at the back of this Meadow Heights home around a year ago. Today, a woman was seen locking up the gate.
Is that Beyza, is it?
No, it's not Beyza.
Nine News has been told Shire Ali's wife raced to the Royal Melbourne Hospital when she heard her husband had been shot. Investigators had been looking for the woman for hours yesterday until she turned up at a local police station. She was interviewed and later released. Today, Home Affairs Minister Peter Dutton said there was no definite link to ISIS.
There's been an amount of forensic activity and examination, but that will continue now for some time, including examination of phones and devices seized.
Just a disbelief. They never thought that such a thing could happen.
Neeri Tai, Nine News.